Are you rolling?
I first started playing bass before I learned any other instrument. For some reason I like the sound of the bass that I heard from my stereo at home. And that was the reason why I decided I should, play bass. I like the rich sound that the instrument produced. When I decided to play professionally, I played on resident contracts with five-star hotels. Now, the resident bands in those days, this is the early 70s in Bombay, every resident band had jazz standards as, part of their repertoire. I was thrown into the deep end. I didn't know anything about jazz standards. I had to join the band and learn on the job. And there was no looking back. I loved what was happening on stage. I loved the freedom that a jazz musician has to express himself on stage. The start of a lifelong passion for me. I experience all kinds of music, and I think that helped me grow as a musician. Jazz has always had a niche following anywhere in the world. It's an acquired taste. People who follow jazz are hooked onto it for life. I love playing jazz. Yes. This is a Goan musician. His name is Manuel. He used to be based in Bombay with me before he migrated to Canada. And I had the opportunity to meet him again after about 25 years, in Goa. And that's when I decided it's a good opportunity to record him. One track actually. He went back to Canada. And we continued the recording online. Not only Manuel is just one. I also recorded a female Canadian saxophonist. Her name is Karen Graves. She was in Goa for a short while. And she was also selected to, perform at the Winter Olympics. So she was quite a big name in Toronto. Most recently, a Canadian singer came over. Her name was Sonia Cotté. Now, Sonia Cotté is also a very Indian name, but she had no connection with India. She was just a Canadian, and she was fond of India because she was into yoga. So she came over and sang. So there's a big Canada-Goa connection happening here. Music is a lifelong learning experience. You're always reaching for the next level. Performing with great artists from around the world makes you reach for the next level. Now, the internet has made it so much easier to collaborate and, record artists from around the world. I have a global recording project where I've been recording artists around the world on one track. It's called Straight No Chaser. Going to be one of the longest ever recorded jazz standard. And you can hear it online at the website called jazzgoa.com. Now, Jazz Goa is an organization I set up. I set it up to record local talent and broadcast them. I have my own radio show here called Goa Grooves. I also produce a television show, and I've been recording artists here absolutely free of cost. When I started off, it was very difficult for me to even dream of having a recording done. But today it's so much easier with technology, and I'm able to help artists who are starting off. It's just my way of giving back to a profession that, really gave me everything in life. Musicians starting off, it's great studying and learning computers and, handling new technology. But you have to remember that music comes from a musical instrument first. So it's always good to be learning and honing your skills on your chosen instrument. And, spending your time with technology at the same time. Lots of musicians today forget that it's the musical instruments that create music. And also performing live, there's nothing to beat the magic of seeing a band perform, music being created by musicians on stage. An exciting experience traveling, meeting musicians from all over the world. My most recent international concert was in Russia, We traveled to a place called Koktebel, and we performed at an international jazz festival there, Goa. It's a very, very musical place. Just about everybody has got music flowing through their veins, And the best part about Goa is you also meet musicians from all over the world. Musicians find Goa a very inspiring place, Very inspiring for any creative artist, actually. The people here are very susegad, as they say. It's just very exciting playing in Goa. The gumot is one of the percussion instruments from Goa. Typical of only of Goa. It's an earthen pot covered with a lizard skin. Always encourage youngsters, we are celebrating International Jazz Day on the 30th of April. This year, I'm featuring a 14-year-old saxophone player and an 83-year-old jazz pianist, three generations apart performing together on stage. Yes, for sure. You're welcome, and thank you for having me on your show. All right, bye-bye.